When a child is having fits, faints, and funny turns, finding the right diagnosis can be challenging. One way is to monitor the brain waves of the child along with the video. This is called video EEG telemetry.
I'm Claire, and me and my son Ryland have come along to the Evelina hospital today so he can have a home telemetry. I'm not sure what to expect, but we'll see how it goes.
Traditionally, it's been done in hospital, but now we can offer the service at home. The child comes in for an appointment, just like a standard EEG. We take a full history, carry out some checks, and then make a short recording. We show you how to use all the equipment and give you instructions and a contact number to call if you have any problems. We show you how to press a button and fill in a sheet if your child has an event. You will have a small recorder, which goes in a bag, and a camera, which goes in a protective briefcase. We'll talk to you about how you're going to get home with all the equipment.
It's great because they give you a number that you can call if you get stuck or you're not sure about something, and a lot of information how to do it as well. So that really helped me, if I'm honest, just in case something went wrong.
Once you get home, you'll need to set up the camera. The first step is to plug it into a wall socket. Next, open the view panel. Press the start/stop button at the back of the camera. Make sure you see a red light on the viewing panel. Attach the infrared light to the top of the camera. Keep the video view panel open. Put the camera in a position where you can see your child from head to toe. You don't need to zoom in or out. If you accidentally close the screen, reopen it and press start/stop to start recording again. If your child moves into another room, bring the camera through and reposition it.
Alan's the kind of kid that you can't keep still. So it's amazing that we can have it done at home, that he can still run around. It's just a normal day for him and it makes no difference, and that's amazing.
If you're recording for more than one night, we'll give you new batteries for the recorder and the infrared light. We'll tell you what time to change them and we'll ask you to set a reminder. At night, you will need to press the night shot button on the camera and turn on the infrared light. This makes sure we can see your child clearly, even in the dark. Don't worry if the bandage comes off or a wire becomes loose. We can still get a good recording. We'll tell you how long to record for. When the recording is finished, cut through the wires and take off the bandage. Then, soak your child's hair in warm water and shampoo. Then you can take the discs off and gently work off the paste. Put all the equipment away and don't forget to put in the sheet. We'll arrange for a courier to collect it. Here are some helpful tips. Make sure the camera is recording. Try not to keep starting and stopping the camera. Try to keep the child in full view of the camera. At night, remember to switch on the night shot function and turn on the infrared light. Remember to change the batteries of the EEG recorder and infrared light. Press the event marker to record any events and record them on the sheet given. Make sure you don't come in front of the camera. Don't position your child in front of a light or a window. The results are usually ready within 4 weeks.
You know, yes, it's daunting, but I promise you, you know, I found it quite easy after that Evelina showed me how to do it properly. And once you turn it on once, it's honestly really easy. Since we've been home, he's been on the trampoline, he's been on the slide, he's been running around, he's been doing every single thing that he does on a normal day, and it hasn't stopped him. That's the best part.